Okay, this has been rattling around my head all week and I just had to get my thoughts out on paper, so that's why I'm doing this. In the epic feature-length special, The Power of the Doctor, we said goodbye to Jodie Whittaker's 13th Doctor in a suitably hopeful and optimistic fashion. But in a surprise twist, the Doctor emerged from the regeneration in a guise all too familiar. That's right, David Tennant has returned to the series not as the 10th Doctor, but the 14th. And just to be clear, that does seem to be the official name for this incarnation. The BBC and Russell T. Davis have confirmed as such. This will be a temporary change, however, since David will lead the 60th anniversary specials next November, before handing the baton over to Ncuti Gatwa, who will apparently debut over the festive season. In short, I don't like this, and I'll try and explain why. I should make it clear that I didn't get into Doctor Who when it returned in 2005. Frankly, I was too young and pretty freaked out by what little I saw of it. But my brother and sister were huge fans and so would eventually show me a handful of episodes, and with the end of time on the horizon, they caught me up on the key stories and the regeneration concept, so I was prepared for New Year's Day. After falling in love with Matt Smith's Doctor and Stephen Moffat's vision for the show, I watched religiously from Series 5 onwards, becoming another obsessed Whovian with autism. Seriously, there's a lot of us. As a result, although I've watched, rewatched, and loved the original Russell T. Davis era of the show, I've never had the emotional attachment to it that many fans and general audiences have. The Doctor is sort of like James Bond in the sense that your favourite is almost always the first one you're introduced to, or the version you grew up with. Although I really struggle to pick a favourite Doctor, Matt Smith and Peter Capaldi will always be up there for me as they were the current Doctors when I was growing up. For a lot of people, this is the case with David Tennant, so he'll always be their favourite, and that's fine. I firmly believe we've never had a bad Doctor, with each actor adding something new to the role and gaining their own dedicated fanbase. But because Tennant's era coincided with the most mainstream success the show had seen in the revival, I think a lot of casual viewers view him as the definitive version, much like Tom Baker was in the classic series. This isn't necessarily a problem, but it's always kind of rubbed me the wrong way. Since I was about 11, I felt like I needed to justify my liking of the show just because my favourite Doctor at the time wasn't quite the hit his predecessor was. This carried on into high school, where I regularly found myself having to defend Moffat and Capaldi and the current direction of the show. While that era is now much more respected in the fandom, when I was first on Twitter, I regularly found myself feeling a Whovian imposter syndrome because I loved a showrunner who wasn't quite loved by the majority. All I saw were people celebrating that this era was ending, and it often made me feel unwelcome in the fandom. And this obviously didn't go away in Jodie's era. If anything, it got worse. It's not even an era I particularly love. I think it's messy, but perfectly enjoyable with a great Doctor at the centre. But the cultural discourse surrounding the show means I've become afraid to even bring it up in casual conversation, knowing I'll have to defend my right to like it. This is kind of an issue in most fandoms now. The Ink Tank did a great video on this. But when it's your favourite show, it's a little sad. There's plenty to love in the Who fandom, great artwork and creators, and I found Twitter a much more welcoming place than some people, especially women, will have. I love this show and the mad, imaginative fans it inspires. I hope this video doesn't come across as me slating this community. I love Whovians. The feedback I got on that Amy video is amazing. So sorry it took me a while to do a follow-up. Getting back to the matter at hand, David Tennant is sort of irreplaceable in the minds of many viewers. He's most people's favourite, and while I obviously don't hold him in such high regard, I get it. He brought an action hero-style charisma to the character, while also giving the role more emotional layers, and we got to see a lot of sides to him over his era. But it's hard for me to separate my feelings on his Doctor and the way fans overly romanticise his tenure. I can't count how many people I've seen and heard rant about how the show hasn't been any good in years and David Tennant will always be the best. I've even seen people say they want Russell to completely retcon the Smith, Capaldi and Whittaker seasons, which is just obnoxiously petty. His time on the show has been put on such a pedestal, like some sort of blueprint for the franchise that every iteration has to follow. There has to be 13 episodes every year because that's what Russell did. The Doctor has to be dark and broody and filled with Time War guilt because that's what David did. The show has to get 7 million viewers every week like David's era, even though it was before iPlayer, streaming was barely a thing, and superhero franchises hadn't taken over entertainment yet. Think how many times you've heard fans complain that Matt Smith or Jodie Whittaker were just doing a David impression. All you're really saying is, they feel like the Doctor. And like a dozen people have played this role now, obviously there's going to be similarities. He's even sort of become the face of the show long after he left it. 9 times out of 10, if a BBC show plays the Doctor Who theme, it'll be his. Internet parodies and spoofs have used his likeness even in the middle of another actor's tenure. And in the middle of Jodie's era, they launched the Time Lord Victorious multi-platform event and promoted the hell out of it, with no real involvement from the current Doctor. This is to say nothing of the Just Skip 9 recommendation that floated around Super Who Lock Tumblr back in the day. I get that he's the most popular and easily recognisable, hence a lot of media will use Tennant to represent the show, but at the same time, if you're not a Doctor Who fan, why would you care which Doctor they're using? All of this and more has kind of cemented the 10th Doctor as irreplaceable and the gold standard in the eyes of many viewers, who will barely give another era of the show a chance. Remember the intense backlash Matt Smith received just for being young and not David? Just reflect on the end of time for a minute. Doesn't it seem a bit in poor taste? While it makes sense for the incarnation with canonical vanity issues, I can't help but feel having Ten spend so much of his final story lamenting that he's going to die, the new man won't be him, and famously not wanting to go kinda tainted how some viewers reacted to Smith's Doctor. It feels especially unfair on Matt, considering he was cast in late 2008, so Russell knew the atmosphere he was entering, but still went in this direction with his regeneration story. With all that said, I don't hate the 10th Doctor. I don't hate any of them, they're all wonderful in their own ways, and he has so many great stories and performances to his name. The Girl in the Fireplace, Human Nature, Midnight are some of my favourite stories of the whole show. But the intense and stubborn pushing of David as the perfect, untouchable portrayal that can't be matched, to me just flies in the face of a show that embraces change. And I know a lot of fans who got into Doctor Who post-Tennant feel the same. As a defence, I kinda developed an annoying gatekeepiness when I was at school, and assumed that fans only liked him because he was popular. I even went through a cynical phase of watching angry reviewers, and made not liking Series 9 my whole personality when I was 15, even though I liked a lot of it. I could get really off-putting really fast, especially with female fans who liked the 10th Doctor most. I became the exact type of fan who would parrot the opinions of others who hated younger fans, and I'm really sorry for that. I couldn't help but feel disheartened when the rumours that David would actually return as the 14th Doctor first emerged. Now, these rumours occur pretty much every year since he left, since for some reason he's always among the bookies' favourites to take over, and I've always dismissed this because it was definitely never going to happen. Except this time his return was announced, and the fact that the BBC were careful not to refer to Ncuti as the 14th made it clear something was going on here. This was an idea I disliked so passionately that when the rumours began to get more plausible, I almost went through the stages of grief with the idea, so by the time the regeneration actually aired, I wasn't even that affected by it. But the more I thought about it and saw how the BBC was marking the occasion, I just got more annoyed with this approach. Recasting the Doctor as a previous actor is something I've always felt the show should never do. The hearts, sorry, I had to, of this show is that everything changes. The programme and its central character are forever evolving, and that's the key to its success and longevity. Reverting the Doctor back into a previous incarnation in such a major capacity just flies in the face of what appeals to me about this show. I've struggled to look forward to Russell's new era because from what we've seen, it just looks like a nostalgia trip for an era I'm not as attached to. I'm sure there'll be plenty to celebrate the show's wider history, and in theory, I'm not against David leading these specials before handing to Ncuti. He's practically a national treasure even outside of Doctor Who, so I can see how this could be a good way to bring in a new audience. We're in the age of nostalgic reunions. The 2010s did this with the 80s, we for whatever reason skipped over the 90s, and now it's the 2000s. Seeing actors return to their iconic characters is cool, and I get that David appearing at the end of the special has the same impact for some people as Andrew and Toby stepping through the portals, or Jackman returning as Wolverine. Hell, I had the same reaction with the classic Doctors appearing. But the difference is, those actors return to their roles years and even decades later. Tobey Maguire even holds the record for the longest superhero career simply because of the 14-year gap between Spider-Man 3 and No Way Home. Hugh Jackman was adamant that Logan was the end, and Andrew Garfield had distanced himself from the franchise through turning to more experimental projects, so their returns have an actual impact. It's surprising. But David Tennant has remained an active part of the Whoniverse for nearly 10 years. The Day of the Doctor, Big Finish, that Muppet show thing. He's returned to the role so much that for me the twist ending doesn't quite have that same thrill. My main issue at the moment comes from him being officially labelled the 14th Doctor. Now the numbering is kinda meaningless after the Timeless Child and was basically just invented by fans anyway, but actually making him a bona fide new incarnation who just looks like and seems to have the exact same personality as the popular one just doesn't work for me. With Tennant being the only actor so far to have done this, in a leading capacity the Curator was just a cameo it again reinforces the idea that he's the only version that matters, and I really don't like that. At least when Joe Martin and John Hurt were introduced, they were given unique titles, so fans had the option to not count them numerically. If they called him the Bridge Doctor, or since it's the 60th, the Diamond Doctor, I wouldn't mind so much. But part of the official numbering, I don't know. I'd understand if the idea was a sort of botched degeneration back into the 10th Doctor, but unless David's going to play the role drastically different, what's the point? The amount of comments I've seen that Russell and David are back to save the show just sounds like they're saying fans who got into it after their era don't matter. Yeah, don't worry about a decade's worth of amazing TV. Here's the one the popular kids like. The BBC even genuinely considered ending the show when he left. Like, no regeneration, the show just ends.
And I think there were plans maybe to consider just ending. I think it was Russell saying you're not allowed to end it, because he's an old fan, and he wouldn't have any time for such an idea.
Even they put him on this ridiculous pedestal. I know this is just temporary. Ncuti will take over next November, and given how in demand he is with shooting Sex Education and Barbie this year, maybe he couldn't commit to a full series or the specials just yet. David's return seems to just be to bridge the gap between the Whittaker and Gatwa eras, and I understand that, but if that's the case, why not just have Ncuti film the end of the regeneration scene, and then have a few standalone specials with Ten and Donna set during Series 4? You can have your cake and eat it too with this. He's literally in the trailer, so they had time to film some stuff with him. Fundamentally, my issue with this whole thing is that the idea of David returning as a new Doctor as a way of bringing in a bigger audience attributes the popularity of the show to one actor, when for me, the central appeal of Doctor Who is its unique ability to constantly renew itself in different ways through a new creative team and a new cast. I don't think Doctor Who necessarily needs star power. I think Doctor Who is what makes people stars, if that makes sense. But obviously I'll watch it. This is my favourite show, when studying filmmaking and working on different projects has made me appreciate just how much thought and work goes into every second on screen, so I always try to be respectful and understand the creative choices a show makes. For all I know, this could actually work and be a new and interesting way to refresh the show. It's certainly got a lot of people talking, and plenty of casual viewers will probably tune in out of interest. And he literally regenerates into a new costume, so clearly something's messing with the process, and there will be some narrative justification for it. But to me, after 12 years of falling in love with the show and all its different incarnations, and constantly feeling a need to justify my liking it, Doctor Who looks like it might just reset into the version it was before I loved it, which feels a bit disappointing. I'm skeptical, but I hope it works.